pressure compensated flow control valve and temperature compensated flow control valve. In this figure, it is combination of both pressure compensation and temperature compensation in the flow control valve. Let us understand what is pressure compensation and what is temperature compensation in detail. We use flow control valves to control the rate of flow of oil. By opening the flow control valve, the area of flow increases and rate of flow will also increase, and vice versa. Means if we close the flow control valve, area of flow will reduce and flow rate will also reduce. But this rate of flow also depends on the pressure of oil and temperature of oil. Rate of flow is depending on area of flow, and we are using that concept to control the rate of flow. But this rate of flow also depends on pressure and temperature also. Hence, any change in the rate of flow which happens due to pressure and temperature variations should be corrected or compensated in order to maintain the required constant flow rate as per the flow control valve settings. That means if we set the flow control valve for a flow of say 5 liter per minute, there will be flow rate of 5 liter per minute. But if pressure at outlet of this valve increases, then due to that pressure at outlet, the flow rate will reduce to certain extent. And in the same way, if temperature of oil is increased, then viscosity will reduce, due to which the flow rate will be slightly higher. So this variation in the flow rate due to pressure and temperature should be compensated. We need 5 liters per minute rate of flow exactly, for which we use this arrangement for pressure compensation and this arrangement for temperature compensation. Let us see what happens if pressure increases at outlet of this flow control valve. If at this outlet of the flow control valve, if pressure is more, then the rate of flow will reduce. To compensate this, we have a mechanism here. Due to this pressure, the pressure will be acting in upward direction on this spool, and the spool will shift in upward direction. The spool will move in upward direction, allowing the passage for oil flow to be increased and allowing more oil to flow through the flow control valve. And if pressure at outlet is reduced, then naturally pressure at inlet will be more and the spool will move in downward direction, so that the flow rate will be reduced and we will get accordingly constant rate of flow. In the same way, if temperature of oil is more, then viscosity of oil will reduce, because of which flow rate will increase. To compensate this, there is a temperature sensing element. It has high thermal expansion. Due to the temperature, due to increase in temperature, this temperature sensing element will expand and it will close this passage slightly, and due to which the rate of flow will reduce. So this much is pressure compensation mechanism and this is temperature compensation mechanism. Pressure compensation mechanism. If inlet pressure is more than the outlet pressure, then rate of flow will be more. To compensate this, in the mechanism, inlet pressure acts on the spool from the top. The spool moves in downward direction. Thus, the area of flow reduces and the flow will reduce to normal. If outlet pressure is more than the inlet pressure, then what happens? The rate of flow will reduce. To compensate this in the mechanism, the outlet pressure acts on the spool from bottom and the spool will move in upward direction. Thus, the area of flow will increase to allow more oil and the flow becomes normal. Temperature compensation mechanism. If the temperature of oil is increased, then naturally, its viscosity will reduce, due to which the rate of flow will increase. To compensate this, In the mechanism, there is a temperature sensitive element. It has higher thermal expansion. It expands due to rise in temperature and reduces the passage for oil to flow. Hence, the flow comes to normal. This valve is pressure and temperature compensated flow control valve. It has mechanism for compensating the rate of flow due to change in pressure and mechanism for compensating the rate of flow due to change in temperature. So both mechanisms are there in this valve. Or if we want to have pressure compensated flow control valve and temperature compensated flow control valve separately, that is also possible. And this valve is pressure compensated flow control valve. It has the mechanism for compensating the rate of flow due to change in pressure. This is temperature compensated flow control valve. It has the mechanism for compensating the rate of flow due to change in temperature.